Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon.
I am Ashutosh Gandhi, contest master for table topic contest, and I welcome you all once again. The purposes of the table topic contest are to provide an opportunity to learn by observing the more proficient speakers who have benefited from the Toastmasters training, to encourage development of impromptu and extemporaneous speaking skills, and to recognize the best as encouragement to all. The first winner will represent our area in the area level contest, which will be held on 22nd April. For this contest, we have 4 contestants. I'm sure the audience is going to have some thrilling time listening to some magnificent impromptu speaking. Let me now set the rules for the contest. I request the audience to maintain absolute silence and no movement during the process of speech. I once again request everyone to please check and switch off your mobile phones or put them in silence mode. 30 seconds time for that. If you are confident, still check. I request all contestants now to hand over their mobile phones to the sergeant at arms, which is Mashdin. And you will collect this once the contest is over.
Small correction, please. Less than 1 minute, not 30 seconds. Less than 1 minute or more than 2.5 minutes.
Speaker number 4, Varunish, B-A-R-U-N-I-S-H. to take the topic or I'll just be clear? I'll go ahead. Okay. Thank you. You just change your labels to this. So I'll take the topic. I request certain terms to escort all the contestants. Except the first contestant, which is Costa. So the adjacent staircase.
Yes.
So we begin the contest. Ladies and gentlemen, the table topics contest shall begin now. Claps.
Excuse me. Is it audible? I think so. It's audible. Okay, take them down.
Rohan. Let them go down. One floor.
So Subhash was checking audibility and he was telling you can come a little forward. Okay, we'll begin with the contest. Contestant number one, Hostel. The topic. Tomorrow is often the busiest day of the week. Tomorrow is often the busiest day of the week. Hostel.
Thank you.
Respected Chief Judge, man wearing multiple hands, contest chair and sergeant at arms, Subhash, contest master and the timing device, ladies and gentlemen and everyone else, good afternoon. Tomorrow is often the busiest day. I have no clue what that means, but I'll tell you something that's very interesting. All these quotations and quips were invented to confuse people. When there isn't anything interesting to say, people come up with these things that make simple people waste their brain power trying to decipher what it is. So in my command, on my watch, let's not do that. I'm going to tell you something more interesting. Have you all heard a puzzle in school or whenever we are growing up? If a tree falls in the forest when there is no one to listen, does it make a sound? Have you heard the puzzle? How many of you have heard the puzzle? Have you ever got an answer to it? You haven't got an answer to it. Now the thing is, there are two types of people. People who remain excited about this kind of a puzzle and keep thinking about it. And there are people who would like to move on, who get an answer to it. And that is why my speech was about finding a passion, a quest, a thirst for finding the answers. And the answer to this question was proposed by Neil deGrasse Tyson, who was a follower, who was a scientist. Well, you've heard probably names of Carl Sagan. He's a follower from Carl Sagan. He's on the same line as Carl Sagan. What he said was, who said the tree fell? There was nobody in the forest to see it fall, because the question says, if there was nobody and the tree fell, then who said the tree fell? So why does there have to be a sound? Now, thank you very much for listening to it. I had absolutely no clue what to talk about the topic, but I'm glad I could share some words of wisdom with you. Thank you very much.